presentation regarding free space laser communication. Okay, now let's see the content. Introduction: what is laser communication, free space laser communication, why laser communication, current applications, advantages, disadvantages, conclusions, and the references. Introduction: what is meant by laser? The word laser is a short form, and the long meaning of the word laser is light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Basic principles of laser: absorption, spontaneous emission, stimulated emission, and the population inversion. So, by these basic principles of laser, a laser beam is generated. What is laser communication? Laser communication is a system of wireless connections through the atmosphere. Here, a laser beam is transmitted through free space. Free space laser communication. By using free space laser communication, videos, data, sound can be easily transmitted by laser beams. And also, free space laser communication helps to communication between space-based systems. Now let us see how does free space laser communication work. First, a signal. This signal may be analog signal or digital signal. This signal subjected to modulation. In the modulation process, there are three main ways of modulation: AM, that means amplitude modulation, PWM or pulse width modulation, then PFM, pulsed frequency modulation. After the signal is modulated, then the modulated signal transmitted by a transmitter, and after this modulated signal transmitted by a transmitter as a laser beam, this laser beam is received by a receiver, then it's subject to demodulation process. So after the demodulation process, it gives back a signal which was before the modulation process. So in the world, there are a lot of communication methods, but among them, why laser communication is so significant. In fiber optic communication, high cost of laying, cannot use in combat zones, high cost for repairs, cables can be damaged. And also in RF communication, that means radio frequency communication, limitations in bandwidth, high power consumption, transmitting and receiving antennas are more bigger. So to avoid these difficulties, free space laser communication is a very good solution. Now let us see the current applications of free space laser communication. Mass communication, that means in television broadcasting and also the phone conversation, nowadays free space laser communication is being used. And also for the military purposes, FSO communication processes, that means free space optical communication process, and also the communication in space based system, that means between satellites, and also between satellite and earth, free space laser communication is being used. And also at the airport, for communication across the runways, laser communication is used. Now let us see the advantages of free space laser communication. Ease of deployment, can use to power devices, full duplex operation, no Fresnel zone, license free long range operation, high bit rates, no effects from electromagnetic interference, and also no spectrum regulation. Disadvantages: beam dispersion, atmospheric absorption, rain, shadowing, interference from background light resources, snow, smog, terrestrial scintillation, pointing stability in wind. So after study these things, the final conclusion is, in near future, free space laser communication will do a revolution in communication field. So there are some words related with physics in my presentation. So here I mentioned the references. So if you are interested in free space laser communication, you can refer these references and you can improve your knowledge. Thank you all for watching my presentation, and have a nice day. Thank you.